Hello friends, our today's session is on the hero as a man of letters. Of course, the session has been prepared on the demand of one of my subscribers. The hero as a man of letters is one of the lectures given by Thomas Carlyle. He gave it on May 19, 1840. It is included in his book entitled Hero and Hero Worship, a collection of 6 lectures. Thomas Carlyle's The Hero as a Man of Letters can be divided into 2 parts. The first part highlights his such ideas as a genuine man of letters, the function of the man of letters, the role of books, etc. While the second part is devoted to the appreciation of the 3 prophets of the 18th century, Dr. Johnson, Rousseau, and Robert Burns. With this brief introduction to the hero as a man of letters, let us jump to our topic. MCQs on The Hero as a Man of Letters. Number 1. Which of the following is true to hero as a man of letters? Options are A. It is one of the lectures by Thomas Carlyle. B. It is included in Carlyle's book entitled Hero and Hero Worship. C. It was delivered on May 19, 1840. D. All these are true. Correct option is D. All these are true. Number 2. Identify from the following the form of heroism of the new age. Options are A. Prophet, B. Poet, C. Priest, D. Man of letters. Correct option is D. Man of letters. Number 3. Which of the following is true to Fichte? Options are A. He is a great teacher of transcendental philosophy. B. He distinguished the genuine man of letters from the fake multitudes. C. To him, man of letters is a prophet. D. All these are true. Correct option is D. All these are true. Number 4. To Fichte, Dasdas is the divine idea of the world. Options are A. The things we see. B. The essence of the appearance. C. Superficialities. D. Practicalities. Correct option is B. The essence of the appearance. Number 5. As Carlyle thinks, the purpose of the existence of a man of letters is Dasdas. Options are A. To write books. B. To show superficialities. C. To teach practicalities. D. To manifest the divine idea of the world. Correct option is D. To manifest the divine idea of the world. Number 6. Identify from the following the notablest of all literary men. Options are A. Goethe, B. Shakespeare, C. Milton, D. None of these. Correct option is A. Goethe. Number 7. Which of the following is true to Carlyle's notion of a man of letters? Options are A. He is the most important modern man. B. He is the light of the world. C. He is the soul of all. D. All these are true. Correct option is D. All these are true. Number 8. Which of the following art has been described as the most miraculous? Options are A. Art of writing. B. Art of printing. C. Art of giving lecture. D. None of these. Correct option is A. Art of writing. Number 9. To Carlyle, the function of man of letters is Dasdas. Options are A. Honorable. B. Highest. C. Both. D. None. Correct option is C, both. Number 10. Thomas Carlyle compares literature to dastas. Options are A, Parliament, B, Democracy, C, Bureaucracy, D, Monarchy. Correct option is A, Parliament. Number 11. Which of the following is true to the books? Options are A, books contain sounds of the past, B, books are vesture of the thought, C, books are the source of man's knowledge, D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number 12, identify from the following the model university for all subsequent universities. Options are A, the University of Paris, B, the University of Oxford, C, the University of Wittenberg, D, the University of Hertfordshire. Correct option is A, the University of Paris. Number 13, to Carlyle, literature is dastas. Options are A, Apocalypse, B, the Parliament, C, the noblest of human achievements, D, all these. Correct option is D, all these. Number 14. To Carlyle, dastas century was a sceptical century. Options are A, 16th, B, 17th, C, 18th, D, 19th. Correct option is C, 18th. Number 15. Which of the following is true to the belief? Options are A, it is healthy act of man's mind, B, it is mysterious process, C, it is indescribable phenomenon, D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number 16, Thomas Carlyle hails dastas as a chronic atrophy and disease of the whole soul. Options are A, skepticism, B, belief, C, worship, D, something else. Correct option is A, skepticism. Number 17, identify from the following the prophet of the 18th century. Options are A, Dr. Johnson, B, Rousseau, C, Robert Burns, D, all these. Correct option is D, all these. Number 18, whom Carlyle describes as a giant invincible soul. Options are A, Dr. Johnson, B, Rousseau, C, Robert Burns, D, somebody else. Correct option is A, Dr. Johnson. Number 19, to Carlyle, Dr. Johnson was dash-dash man. Options are A, original, B, second hand, C, borrowing, D, begging. Correct option is A, original. Number 20, whom Carlyle calls the last of the Romans. Options are A, Fichte, B, Guto, C, Dr. Johnson, D, Shakespeare. Correct option is C, Dr. Johnson. Number 21, which of the following is true to Rousseau? Options are A, he was morbid, excitable and plasmodic. B, he was intense rather than strong. C, he lacks the talent of silence. D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number 22, identify from the following a sadly contracted hero. Options are A, Fichte, B, Dr. Johnson, C, Rousseau, D, Robert Burns. Correct option is C, Rousseau. Number 23, according to Carlyle, dastas is the weakness of Rousseau. Options are A, egoism, B, earnestness, C, fierceness, D, none of these. Correct option is A, egoism. Number 24, the heroic trait in Rousseau's personality is dust up. Options are A, earnestness, B, depth and width, C, calm force for the difficulty, D, fierceness. Correct option is A, earnestness. Number 25. Which of the following is true to the books of Rousseau? Options are A, they are unhealthy, B, there is sensuality, C, they are not genuinely poetic, D, all these are true. Correct option is D, all these are true. Number 26. Pick out from the following the evangelist of the French Revolution. Options are A, Rousseau, B, Fichte, C, Guiteau, D, Mirabeau. Correct option is A, Rousseau. Number 27. Carlyle compares Robert Burns to Dastas. Options are A, a little well in the rocky desert places, B, a sudden splendor in heaven in the artificial Vauxhall, C, both, D, none of these. Correct option is C, both. Number 28. Carlyle finds Burns' similarity with Dastas. Options are A, Mirabeau, B, Rousseau, C, Milton, D, Fichte. Correct option is A, Mirabeau. Number 29. Which of the following is the peculiarity of Robert Burns' poetry? Options are A, element of mirth, B, earnestness, C, abundance of hope, D, all these. Correct option is D, all these. Number 30. Whom Carlyle labels as the most gifted soul of the 18th century? Options are A, Robert Burns, B, Dr. Johnson, C, Rousseau, D, none of these. Correct option is A, Robert Burns.